crank it in, mate.
Yeah, let's just get one on the deck.
Let's get some dinner.
Here we go, we got colour.
Blue nose.
Swordfish bait.
Thank you. Right, well there you go. Just about better use that as a whole bait, that one, to be honest. It would be a tasty little critter. Now, while that little critter there is very tasty, to me that's a sign. You catch blue nose, you can catch swords.
Has something had a go at it?
No, you're right, something has had a go at it. Swordfish whack.
Bang.
Bang. There you go, mate. So just while we're dropping down another bait, I'm going to start cleaning up this fish. Of course, we keep the head, keep the wings, belly, swordfish baits, and the top is going to come, top of the fillet's going to be our dinner. But whenever I'm cleaning up these deep sea fish, particularly blue nose, they got this real snotty, you can see it there, goo on them, a mucus that they excrete from their skin to keep parasites off them. It makes a mess of your fillets and it actually tastes bitter. So if that slime there ends up on your fillet, it goes off quicker. It goes off about 5 times as fast. So if you clean them before you even put them on your filleting board, better quality fillet, that'll last longer, tastes better. See this stuff? That there is a pelagic sea squirt. Sea squirt that never in its life will connect itself to a rock. Just floats around the ocean. And you mark big clouds of it on the sounder. We've marked one before, I think, but we couldn't relocate it again, and that's what the blue nose eat.
And swordfish.
What's that?
And no,
the swordfish don't eat that. I've never seen it inside them. The swordfish will just, like, these blue nose, this size are like candy bars for your swords.
If you're after more info on how to catch these tasty blue nose, or a whole range of other deep water fish, we've got loads of videos on how to find them, how to make the rigs, and how to catch them. And because wherever you find blue nose, you also find swordfish, we can show you the rigs and how to catch swordfish too. And then, if you decide to keep your swordfish, we've got videos on how to process swordfish and all kinds of fish. Pretty much anything fish or fishing related, you can find it and watch it for free at ultimatefishing.tv.